boats, Bowen was to cry, when the brave were come to die, when the end was drawing nigh, boats, Bowen was the cry.
The public's curiosity about the Titanic has never been fully sated. It's a story of sacrifice. It's a story of men knowing that they're going to their deaths and being okay with that.
The whole egalitarian approach is really a derivative of the survival of the fittest idea that comes out of Charles Darwin. I mean, we lose biblical gender roles. We lose the idea that we are created in the image of God with certain responsibilities as men or as women.
We have to remember that feminism is not simply about the rights of women, but it's about the removal of gender distinctions.
The fathers have too many diversionary activities. They have things that just get in the way of the discipleship of their children.
The idea of women and children first is something that has been part of Western civilization's inheritance, but we have lost so much of that today. And now it's pretty much every man for himself.
We're getting more stunning images from Italy of the battered Costa Concordia.
The Concordia was more than 3 nautical miles off course when it hit the underwater rock.
Very much like the Titanic, as people have been noting all day, this appears to have made a rip down the side of the ship.
It became a situation of every man for themselves.
There are new audio recordings also showing that the captain may have lied to rescue workers.
To live like a man is to live in obedience to the laws of God.
God is the creator. If we don't submit to God's rules and God's definitions for manhood and for life, we will see our systems breaking down. If we don't fix this one, if the church does not speak to this one, we are dead. We are not going to survive. That's just the tip of the iceberg.